I in total concur with you that Nigeria is not at war. At most, what we are facing is series of security challenges across the nooks and crannies of the country that we need to think out of the box with a view to preparing solutions to the lingering security challenges that we are facing across the nooks and crannies of this country. Against this backdrop, Mr. Speaker, I support this motion because this bill, because the primary responsibility of any government is to guarantee the peace, order, and good governance of the country. That is the primary responsibility of any government. And as such, such a duty should always be in the front burner of whatever government is doing. Against this background, Mr. Speaker, the need to establish a fund that will cater for the funding of our armed forces cannot be overemphasized, because no nation on earth funds its security or its armed forces through the normal budgetary line. Countries like Brazil, Egypt, and even the United States of America also go outside the normal budgetary line to fund the activities of their armed forces. And here in Nigeria, the armed forces even have the additional burden of now engaging in duties that are ordinarily supposed to be done by the police. Issues of armed banditry, issues of kidnapping that is now everywhere across the nooks and crannies of the country are issues that are ordinarily supposed to be dealt with by the police. But because of the fact that the police is overstretched, our armed forces are now everywhere in the theater of conflict, everywhere across the nooks and crannies of the country. So they are overstretched. So there is need for us to think out of the box and then source for other alternative means of funding them so that they can effectively tackle these problems that constitute a threat to the territorial integrity of this country. As such, I support the second reading of this bill. Thank you.